So first, I will introduce. So my name is Danielle Groth, and I am a clinical EFT practitioner, and I have my own practice here in Ann Arbor, Michigan, and I help people deal with stress and anxiety, phobias, a lot of different emotional issues. And then this is my friend and colleague, Pastor Vicki Lovell, which apparently many of you know from, she leads a lot of the different groups here. And we together, we blend our prayer and tapping, and we do something called timeline mending together, where we take people's stories from basically birth on, finding some of the traumas and the big stressors, and we help to identify them and help people to look at their stories a little bit differently and work on their perspective. And it really helps to help you to understand yourself in dealing with your stress and your anxiety, and realizing that you've been through a lot. your stories are big and they're important, and there's a reason that you respond and react the way that you do. And it's helpful when you bring those things into your awareness and understand yourself to how to deal with some of these things. So we're going to touch a little bit on that today. Vicki's going to monitor the chat. So if questions and stuff come up, you're welcome at any time to unmute and raise your hand. And for those of you who feel comfortable actually coming on the screen, once we start tapping, at least, it's really helpful for me to see people as we're tapping. Because we're going to get right, I'm just going to only really briefly explain tapping. There's a lot of information out there that you can Google and take the time to learn about it, but I actually want to tap with you today. I want to help you work with some of this stuff, but I also want you to know that it can get a little bit messy. There's some emotions and stuff that might come up today as we're doing this, and so if something does come up, if you need to stay a little bit after or figure out a way to talk with me, I'm happy to do that. If we need to do a different breakout room where maybe Pastor Vicki can take you to the side, and you know, she's also versed in how to do this and can help you work through some of it. So if something starts to come up during this presentation and arise in you, please share it with us so that we can help you. We don't want to leave you feeling uncomfortable or adding to your stress and anxiety today. So with that, tapping is one of the most directed and powerful ways to peel away layers of chronic stress. And tapping is actually, you're tapping on your body, and we're going to get into showing you how to do that. And it works quite quickly. But first, I just want you to understand really what stress does to your body and what the effects of it can. It can create fatigue. It can actually change your skin texture, cause you to have dry skin or thinner skin. It affects your blood flow, how you absorb nutrients and your whole digestive system, which I'm sure many of you are experienced and aware of that. It does decrease your immunity when you are stressed, and you'll find a lot of people, right, will finally go on that vacation or go spend time and do something, and you've been building up, and so you may be working really hard at getting everything ready to go, and then you get there, and you're like, really, now is when I get the flu or a cold or something. Well, it's finally because your immune system chills out for a moment, or your stress and stuff calms down, but your immune system is weakened. And maybe you've been on a plane with a bunch of people or something happened. So that's how your immunity then gets kicked down. It can create hormonal imbalances in your body. It's just got a lot of big effects that actually your emotions create physical things if it happens long enough. And what you'll find is that anxiety and stress, they raise our adrenaline and our cortisol, which those are our fight, flight, or freeze hormones. And so what I'd like to try to show people is, if you imagine this being your brain, and so your wrist and your arm is kind of like your brain stem, and then the front of your fist or your fingers is the frontal cortex of your brain. And that's the part of your brain that can think and is, you know, it's just kind of always online. It knows right from wrong. And then underneath that is this little almond-shaped piece called the amygdala. And that's your fight, flight, or freeze. That is your survival mechanism. It's the oldest part of your brain, the reptilian part of your brain. Well, when you get into a moment of panic, you flip your lid. These two parts of your brain can't work at the same time. And so what happens when you flip your lid and the amygdala kicks in and it starts pouring out that cortisol and the adrenaline, it's actually a brain drain. And the blood will come and go to your extremities because it wants to save your life. It can't tell the difference between you being originally what it was designed for as you were being attacked by the saber-toothed tiger in, you know, out in the middle of nowhere, and it needed to save you. Now, you know, it could be that, you know, upsetting text or email or something that you got, or maybe there's another medical bill or something that you got that it sets it all off. And when you honestly can't think straight or speak clearly, it's not that it's that you're not intelligent or that you're not getting it. It's just you honestly don't have the blood in your brain to make your brain work the way that it should work. And so what I'm going to show you through tapping is how to keep that lid down or how to get it back down once it's flipped so that you can stay present in the moment of whatever it is that you're dealing with and you're able to cope with it and able to do your best to understand and grasp what's really happening with you. So what is the difference between stress and anxiety? Because a lot of us use those words interchangeably, and they're not really the same thing. So stress is caused by an external trigger. It's a response to a threat or a situation. So the stress could be being stuck in traffic, or you know, your kid's doing not so well in school and you're having an argument about something, or they won't you know, behave in a certain way, or your spouse does something to you. And something happens, but it eventually goes away. You work through it. Anxiety is an internal reaction to stress where it becomes a persistent worry. And that's often where I think a lot of you are finding yourselves with the issues that you're constantly dealing with. There's always a worry. There's always a concern of something that you're dealing with, something big all the time. And that becomes this anxiety. And the anxiety is often where you start to feel, you know, those headaches and the difficulty sleeping, or just general that fatigue that you have, or you can get really angry, or your digestive system doesn't work, or you have muscle pains. They're similar with stress, as you know, they're the two similar things, but with the anxiety, it just doesn't seem to ever go away. And that's how some of you feel. You get to the point where it's just, it always hurts. You're always tired and you find yourself using that word always. And so tapping is going to be a way that we can help you to maybe start to shift that sentence a little bit. And you can use it to help relieve headaches, to help relieve some stomach issues in the moment that you're having them, and really help you to feel a little bit more control over how your body is reacting and responding to things. So what is tapping? So tapping is the easy way, because it's literally what you're doing is you're tapping on these points, which I'll show you soon. But it stands for, it's actually called EFT, which is emotional freedom techniques. It's based off of the Chinese medicine and the body's energetic meridian system, as well as modern psychology and cognitive talk therapy. And there's a ton of studies that are out there. It's becoming more and more known. It's considered the fourth generation of psychology that people are using, and people are blending into their practices now as they see how powerful it works, how quickly it works, and that it's actually rewiring the brain to respond in a healthier way. So people with PTSD, they're finding that it's not just that it goes away in the moment. It's actually fixing things, it's changing things. It's no longer a trigger, it's no longer an issue. And 6 months to a year later, they're still finding that trigger is gone. And even further now that these studies have been going on for a while. So this is something that is definitely a tool that's worth having into your tool belt. And it's this calming signal sent to your brain, reminding your brain that it's not in danger all of the time, because a lot of people end up feeling this way when they get stuck in this cycle. So a question I want to ask you as we go forward and we're going to start tapping is, what belief are you holding onto that is actually hijacking your brain? It's creating this environment of stress and overwhelm because your thoughts are really, really important. Your brain, as wonderful and brilliant as you can be, it's actually not all that smart sometimes, where, you know, I could be looking out the window and it's storming outside. And sometimes a lot of us, when it's storming and it's cloudy, it makes us not feel so great. We get maybe a little bit tired, or if it's snowing outside, you just end up feeling cold. But if you close your eyes and you start to visualize, you know, a beach or the sunshine, or, you know, something that's a little bit cheerier for you, you will find that you will start to change. And they can do this with an fMRI, and they watch how the brain responds. And your thoughts are actually changing responses to your body of what's happening. Your body will get warmer. Your body's heartbeat and blood pressure will calm down, especially if you're, you know, visualizing a space that makes you happy. And it's because your brain, it doesn't know if what's actually real or not. It's what you're telling it. And so when we get caught up sometimes in some of these stories that we tell ourselves, or these fears that we have, that rightfully so, because there's been so many difficulties in the past, that why, once you start to think this way, your body gets ready for it and it prepares for something that's maybe not actually happening in the current moment. And that's what tapping is going to help us to work through. Before I start with the tapping points, I don't know if anyone can, if they want to ask a question or say anything in the chat before we move on to this. Yeah. All right, so I'm going to show you the tapping points, and then we're going to move on to doing some actual tapping. So you're going to start with it doesn't matter what hand, you just pick whichever hand, and the side where your pinky is at, just down where it's a little bit fatter on the side of your hand. You take your other hand with just a couple of fingers, and you gently are going to tap. This point is called the karate chop point. And this is what we will have a setup statement, where we are going to focus on the issue that we're going to tap on. And I'll explain more about that in just a moment. After we do that, we're going to come up to this eyebrow point. So it's right between kind of where your eyebrow ends and your curve of your nose starts. And again, you just take a couple of fingers. Some people do like to use both hands. It's up to you, and you can change partway through. And then you go to the side of the eye, closer to where the bone is at. And then you're going to tap under the eye, again, where your bone is at, under your nose, in the crease of your chin. And if you feel where your collarbone's at, you're going to go just where it's a little bit softer, and you're going to tap there. And these are called your sore spots. And you can, you can't do anything else other than this. You'll find yourself sometimes, right, maybe just kind of rubbing on your chest. It's a natural spot on our body that helps to calm us. So know that you always have this spot in the middle of a situation to deal with. Under your arm, just a few inches under, it's often where a tank top falls, your bra strap is at, or and then on the top of your head. And those are all of the tapping points. And we'll go through a series then of statements that go along with it. So what happens when you get started with tapping is you will focus on the negative. And you're going to focus on the negative. People are like, why, right? Everybody always tells me to be positive. And sometimes you actually just want to punch them in the face, right? When you're thinking about the positive, and especially with some of the big issues that you have to deal with. Sometimes you're like, there is nothing positive. So I'm not asking you to focus on anything positive. This is the time when you can say all the things that you're really thinking and feeling. It's okay. I'm giving you permission to say out loud or in your head, all of your fears, your worries, your stresses, your concerns. You're feeling them and you're thinking them. So we need to put that out there and acknowledge it and allow yourself to process those, because it's real. And it matters what you think and what you feel. And so instead of burying it down and hiding it in your body, this is the opportunity for you to get it out. So that's where this karate chop point comes in. It's what's considered your most pressing issue. And what's helpful is when you think about it, so we're going to get to one and we'll just say, so even though I have all this stress in my body right now, and I feel it in this terrible headache I have, I accept how I feel and I'm okay. So you want to acknowledge if you where you're feeling in your body, and you want to actually feel this in your body for this issue. So when you come up with it, so some people it'll actually just be physical pain and that makes it kind of easy, but maybe you're just really angry at something and you need to get that anger out and work that anger up. So it's closing your eyes for a moment and asking yourself, where in my body am I feeling this anger? For some people, it's just, you know, kind of this clenching and you're like, oh, I'm feeling it in my jaw because I'm clenching that. Or it's a heaviness in your chest. It can be a grumbling in your stomach. It can be nervous energy in your body. Maybe you're waiting for a phone call with some information and you just kind of feel all sort of jittery. And then you're going to give it that number of 0 to I don't feel it at all to 10. It's extremely intense. And you're doing that just so that you can help yourself identify how it's processing and working for you. And then you craft that setup statement. So you're going to say, you know, even though I'm waiting for this phone call and I have no idea what the answer is going to be, and I'm so full of nervous energy right now, I accept how I feel and I'm okay. And what you're saying is that even though I have this problem, I'm safe, I'm okay, I'm forgiven, or I can show myself some compassion. And it's sending this message to your brain that even in this problem, I can remain calm. You don't have to save my life right now. You don't have to send out that adrenaline and that cortisol. You don't have to turn it all on right now and make me all panicky. I'm in control. And your brain is going to be like, well, gosh, if she was really running for her life right now, would she have time to be tapping on these points? Okay, maybe I can start to believe her that she's actually not in a really bad place right now. And I can try to keep that frontal cortex part of the brain turned on. And then after you go from this hand, we're going to go to all these other points. And these are reminder phrases. And this is where it can be the same exact word that gets repeated. It can just be this headache, or you can add something more specific to it. This headache. Oh my gosh, I am so angry at my spouse. I can't believe he would do that. Doesn't he know better? Whatever that may be. And then you'll pause and you'll check in with yourself. So again, it's kind of closing your eyes and saying, do I still feel this anger or this nervous energy? And if it's gone away, then you've been able to work through it. If maybe it's moved for you, that's possible. It's actually oftentimes of what can happen. Maybe sometimes the headache, it moves from the front of the head to the back of the head. And so now you tap on that and why it is. For some people, they will yawn. That yawn is usually a shift that happens. Some people actually get really, really tired after doing this. And it's the body just kind of processing through some of it. And sometimes the weirdest things come up in your mind and you're doing this and you're like, wow, I'm thinking about this, you know, this event that happened in the playground when I was in third grade. I have no idea why. Well, your brain is actually telling you, it's getting you to the root of why maybe you're so angry right now. Because your brain learned how to deal with anger during this incident on the playground. And it's become the trigger and it's become this quick way to get to what's happening. And so it's best then to tap through that event. And there's a lot to tapping. You'll watch videos and things online. There's the tappingsolution.com. There's a ton of YouTube videos and they're great to do. The tricky part is when you do something generic, it doesn't always feel like it fits, or sometimes you get caught in something and you don't know what to do next. So I invite you to do this, but to do it with a little bit of caution and to understand that there are clinicians like myself that are out there so that if you do get stuck or you do need deeper help and you find that this is a useful tool, it's really best to get with a professional that can help you to process it all the way through instead of just partial. But it is a great tool to have in your own tool belt if you're in the middle of something happening and you need to really kind of get back in your body and get back in your headspace so that you can be the best caregiver that you can be, that you can have the conversations that you need to have and be in that healthy headspace. So we are going to actually get tapping. So I was told that one of the issues that a lot of people here in this group are dealing with is this feeling of stress around COVID, and that the world is kind of getting back to normal, but unfortunately, there isn't really a normal for a lot of the caregivers and the families that are here. And so I wanted to give you an opportunity as a group that we can tap on this together. And one of the benefits of though tapping with the group is it's called borrowed benefits, that we share in each other's energy and we can help each other out. So maybe this doesn't relate to you right now. That's okay. Please tap along with it anyways. And that's why if you can, I invite those of you who feel comfortable turning on your screens so that each of you can sort of see each other or be in that space together. And you can help out your fellow caregiver with sharing of this energy. But if not, that's okay too. But what I'll do is I will walk through. I'm going to do this. I will say these things first, and then you will repeat after me. And we'll just kind of go through all of this, and we'll pause after this one, and then we can ask any questions that are coming up. And then Vicky's going to join me and kind of model along with so that you'll understand a little bit more how all of this works. So what I invite you to do is just thinking about this topic of stress and COVID and dealing with it, and how do you feel about it? And so if it is an issue for you, then asking yourself, when you do think about it, where do you feel it? And some of these sentences might not make sense to you or fit exactly. If you feel comfortable, you're welcome to change it and say it how you want to say it. It doesn't have to be. I'm just was kind of guessing based on doing this as a group. So we're going to come to the side of the hand. And again, remembering it doesn't matter what hand. And we're going to come to down here. And then you'll repeat after me. And then you can read it as well. Even though I'm feeling the stress and frustration about COVID. And how people are dealing with it. I honor and accept my feelings. And this you do three times. So even though I'm feeling this stress and frustration about COVID. And how people are dealing with it. I honor and accept my feelings. One more time. Even though I'm feeling the stress and frustration about COVID. And how people are dealing with it. I honor and accept my feelings. So now we come to this eyebrow point up here. We say all the stress over COVID. Side of the eye. It's been constant. Under the eye. It's always here. Under the nose, it's always everywhere. Under the mouth, wear a mask. Collarbone, you don't need to wear a mask. Under the arm, everybody's vaccinated. Top of the head, those that are not vaccinated. Back to the eyebrow. The thought of COVID is still so scary. Side of the eye. Will it ever go away? Under the eye. Everyone seems to be starting life again. Under the nose. But we can't. Under the mouth. COVID is still a huge fear in my household. The collarbone. It is safer for me and my family to stay home. Under the arm. Some people in my house are going back to work. Top of the head. Some are heading back to school. The eyebrow. Everyone seems to be moving on and life is happening. Side of the eye. But here we are stuck at home. Under the eye. I am so isolated. Under the nose, it's isolation. Under the mouth, we are all still isolated. The collarbone, This isolation is lonely.
This isolation is lonely.
Under the arm for all of us.
For all of us.
Top of the head. My child needs to get out.
My child needs to get out.
Back to the eyebrow. And I'm so frustrated.
I'm so frustrated.
Side of the eye. So tired of living with all this fear.
So tired of living with all of this fear.
Under the eye. Perhaps I could release some of this frustration.
Perhaps I could release some of this frustration.
Under the nose. This fear is real.
This fear is real.
Under the mouth. The isolation is real.
The isolation is real.
The collarbone. And I'm open to releasing the grip of this fear.
I'm open to releasing the grip of this fear.
Under the arm. Releasing the grip of fear now.
Releasing the grip of fear now.
Top of the head. I cannot change or hurry COVID up.
I cannot change or hurry COVID up.
One more slide here. Back to the eyebrow point. However, I choose to respond to it in a new way.
However, I choose to respond to it in a new way.
Side of the eye. I'm choosing to let go of the fear.
I'm choosing to let go of the fear.
Under the eye. Releasing even a little fear now.
Releasing even a little fear now.
Under the nose. COVID is real.
COVID is real.
Under the mouth. But I choose to do my best to take care of myself.
I choose to do my best to take care of myself.
The collarbone. Releasing stress and anxiety boosts my immunity.
Releasing stress and anxiety boosts my immunity.
Under the arm. Eating well and resting boosts my immunity.
Eating well and resting boosts my immunity.
The top of the head. So I give myself permission to relax in my body.
I give myself permission to relax my body.
And boost my immunity.
Boost my immunity.
And be in the best shape I can be for my child.
And be in the best shape that I can be for my child.
Pause and take a nice deep breath in and out. And kind of check in with your body and see what it feels of just sort of saying all of these things. And I'd love it if anybody wants to share, has a response, any questions that come up with what they've experienced. If there's anyone wants to share something. Well, hopefully you are able to feel a little relief or maybe an understanding of how it works and processes in the body. But as you do this and as you tap through each of these points and you, you know, give a voice to what's actually happening in your body, you're helping your brain to understand that it can create new pathways to something different. So on some of the phrases where I say, like, I'm choosing to let go of the fear now, the choosing part, you're saying that because if you say, I don't want to be afraid, or I don't want to be scared of COVID, your brain actually doesn't understand the don't. Like some of you might understand if you say, if you're on a diet and you're like, I don't want to eat that cookie. Your brain says, all it hears is eat that cookie. What you want to say is, I'm choosing to eat the apple. I would like to eat the apple. Telling it what it wants and not what it doesn't want. It struggles to understand that don't part of it, especially when the emotional side of you really wants that cookie, right? Your taste buds and stuff are looking at it. Your brain knows what that cookie tastes like, and it knows how happy it makes your mouth and how happy it makes your body. So you saying don't, your brain's like, yeah, right, you don't want it. Like, come on. And you start salivating and you want it. So it's the same way when you're dealing with the stress and the anxiety. It's being careful of the words that you choose so that you're communicating in a way that your brain can understand what it is that you truly want.
2:30. Is it 2:30?
Okay. So we're going to go through one more tapping script here. We have a few minutes left that we can do this. And so I know that I've been told that there's a lot of the times where there's some really big moments that happen in your lives where there's emergencies that take place, or diagnoses that happen, something new comes up. And when you're in that moment of panic and stress, like I said, your brain gets hijacked. And so this is something that you can do to help yourself in the moment of what's happening so that you can do your best to remain present. Because what will happen is, for a lot of you, this, you know, an event will happen that's not your first rodeo, and it's been really difficult in the past. And so your brain says, oh, this has happened, and so here's what's happened in the past. Get ready. Let's, you know, we got to get going on this. But maybe this time it's going to be, you know, a little bit different, or it will happen at a different pace. And so, or it might just happen just as scary as it has in the past, but you can respond to what's happening a little bit differently. And so the phrases and stuff that we're going to use are helping you to know that the story and what you're dealing with is real and true, but how you can take it in these little bits and pieces, and you don't have to automatically go to what the ending was maybe last time it happened to you, and to take it to the catastrophic ending or you know, a stopping point of where something happened, that you can stay present and just take what's happening each moment at a time and dealing with it. So we're going to start again with that side of the hand. And then close your eyes for a moment, and you might actually be dealing with this right now. And so whatever it is, just asking yourself, where is it that you're feeling this in your body? So if there's an event that you would like some help with, and it can be a past event that you want your body to process and calm down about, because you're thinking about it now brings it all up and you feel it. And so where do you feel it in your body? Is it a knot in your stomach? Is it a heaviness in your chest or a pounding of your heart? And then give it that rating of 0 being low intensity to 10 being very intense. And then opening up your eyes and repeating after me. Even though my brain is being hijacked.
Even though my brain is being hijacked.
By the scary story of what could happen.
By the scary story of what could happen.
I acknowledge how I feel.
I acknowledge how I feel.
And I give my body permission to relax.
And I give my body permission to relax.
Even though my brain is being hijacked.
Even though my brain is being hijacked.
By the scary story of what could happen.
By the scary story of what could happen.
I acknowledge how I feel.
I acknowledge how I feel.
And I give my body permission to relax.
And I give my body permission to relax.
Let me do this one more time. Even though my brain is being hijacked.
Even though my brain is being hijacked.
By the scary story of what could happen.
By the scary story of what could happen.
I acknowledge how I feel.
I acknowledge how I feel.
And I give my body permission to relax.
And I give my body permission to relax.
So now we come up to this eyebrow point. I'd say this current catastrophe.
This current catastrophe.
In the side of the eye. I don't know what's lurking.
I don't know what's lurking.
Under the eye, the scary story of what I'm telling myself.
The scary story of what I'm telling myself.
Under the nose, it's hijacking my brain.
It's hijacking my brain.
Under the mouth, it's making me so anxious.
It's making me so anxious.
Collarbone, my body feels like it's on high alert.
My body feels like it's on high alert.
This is something that could really happen.
This is something that could really happen.
Top of the head. It's so scary to think about this story.
It's so scary to think about this story.
Coming back to the eyebrow. Part of me knows not to believe this story.
Part of me knows not to believe this story.
Side of the eye. But another part of me knows it could be real.
But another part of me knows it could be real.
Under the eye. And I feel this anxiety in my body.
And I feel this anxiety in my body.
Under the nose. But what I'm thinking about hasn't actually happened.
But what I'm thinking about hasn't actually happened.
Under the mouth. I'm imagining what could happen.
I'm imagining what could happen.
Collarbone. So releasing the need to believe this story.
Releasing the need to believe this story.
Under the arm. I'll focus on what I do know.
I will focus on what I do know.
Top of the head, and let go of the rest of this story.
And let go of the rest of the story.
Back to the eyebrow. I'm frustrated with myself for being so anxious.
I'm frustrated with myself for being so anxious.
Side of the eye. And I give my mind permission to take a break.
And I give my mind permission to take a break.
under the eye. This isn't fair. I don't want to be going through this.
This isn't fair. I don't want to be going through this.
Under the nose. I don't know what's going to happen.
I don't know what's going to happen.
Under the mouth. I'm so upset and anxious.
I'm so upset and anxious.
Collarbone. But I'm also safe right now.
But I'm also safe right now.
Under the arm. And I'm choosing to be calm right now so I can relax in my body.
And I'm choosing to be calm right now so I can relax in my body.
Top of the head. It's important that I stay focused right now.
It's important that I stay focused right now.
One more round here. So back to the eyebrow. I will make it through this moment.
I will make it through this moment.
Side of the eye. I choose to focus on what I can control.
I choose to focus on what I can control.
Under the eye. And I let go of the rest of the story.
And I let go of the rest of the story.
Under the nose. I choose to stop worrying about everything that could happen.
I choose to stop worrying about everything that could happen.
Under the mouth. And I choose to feel safe in this moment.
And I choose to feel safe in this moment.
Collarbone. Releasing the story I'm telling myself.
Releasing the story I'm telling myself.
Under the arm. Allowing myself to feel calm and releasing this worry.
Allowing myself to feel calm and releasing this worry.
On the top of the head, feeling calm and safe in the present moment.
Feeling calm and safe in the present moment.
Pausing, taking that nice deep breath in. And seeing again what comes up in your body. I'm not sure how everybody's feeling here. Maybe just type in a couple of things in the chat, even just a word of how you're feeling, or is this relating to you? So I kind of engage where we're at here. So there's
feeling calm and relaxed.
I have some additional another script if we wanted to try some more, or if there's some questions or some more information you'd like to know about tapping, I am be open to trying to kind of guide however I can best help all of you in this moment of what it is that you would like to know about tapping, or it's saying if you'd like to go. There's another one here on just the idea of stress and overwhelm in the body. So I don't know if something has come up for somebody and we want to work through something specific for you, whatever that is, we can do that too. Any questions on the points or?
One more.
Yeah. All right. So I will go ahead and do this one more script here if we're feeling okay with it. So this one is just kind of covering the overall generalness of feeling stressed and overwhelmed. So whether it's about your child and being a caregiver, or even just in general, right? Life is just stressful. And you know, so many of you have other children as well. It's not always just about you know, the one, or and just even other family members. This is something that you can use. So I invite you again to take that moment, start tapping on the side of the hand and breathing in. And just asking yourself, where are you feeling stress in your body right now? The tightness in your neck, or your shoulders kind of up to your ears. Is it a heaviness in your chest? Knot in your stomach. Some people, your knee hurts, your hip hurts, your toe hurts. Sometimes just random parts of your body will hurt. And that's a lot of the time stress showing up. So acknowledging where that's at, giving it its number from 0 to 10, 10 being the high intensity. And then open your eyes and we'll get started on this script here. So even though I'm feeling the stress and overwhelm in my body,
even though I'm feeling the stress and overwhelm in my body,
I accept how I feel and I'm okay.
I accept how I feel and I'm okay.
Even though I'm feeling the stress and overwhelm in my body, and you can name that point. So maybe it's in your shoulder.
Even though I'm feeling the stress and overwhelm in my body,
I accept how I feel and I'm okay.
I accept how I feel and I'm okay.
One more time. Even though I'm feeling this stress and overwhelm in my body.
Even though I'm feeling this stress and overwhelm in my body.
I accept how I feel and I'm okay.
I accept how I feel and I'm okay.
Come back up to the eyebrow point. All this stress in my life.
All this stress in my life.
Side of the eye. All this stress in my body.
All this stress in my body.
Under the eye. It's always there.
It's always there.
Under the nose. There is no way for me to relax.
There's no way for me to relax.
The chin. I have too much to stress over.
I have too much to stress over.
The collarbone. All this stress in my body.
All this stress in my body.
Under the arm. All this tightness in my body.
All this tightness in my body.
The top of the head. Sometimes everything hurts so much.
Sometimes everything hurts so much.
Come back to eyebrow point. All this stress.
All this stress.
Side of the eye. These feelings of overwhelm.
These feelings of overwhelm.
Under the eye. It's a struggle every day.
It's a struggle every day.
Under the nose. I don't know any other way.
I don't know any other way.
In the chin. I just keep moving and shifting.
I just keep moving and shifting.
Collarbone. I just keep busy.
I just keep busy.
Under the arm. I can't stop, so I don't focus on the pain.
I can't stop, so I don't focus on the pain.
On top of the head. Or I'll focus on the pain in my body and in my spirit.
Or I'll focus on the pain in my body and in my spirit.
Come back to the eyebrow point. I'm not sure I know how to stop.
I'm not sure I know how to stop.
Side of the eye. Stopping means I will feel the pain.
Stopping means I'll feel the pain.
Under the eye. And if I have an honest conversation with myself.
If I have an honest conversation with myself.
Under the nose. And I allow myself to look into my feelings of stress.
And allow myself to look into my feelings of stress.
And overwhelm.
And overwhelm.
Under the mouth. I'm scared.
I'm scared.
Collarbone. I've been moving at this pace for so long.
I've been moving at this pace for so long.
Under the arm. I don't know any other way.
I don't know any other way.
Top of the head. I might not recognize myself without the hurt and pain.
I might not recognize myself without the hurt and pain.
Back to the eyebrow. Maybe I can be open to the possibility of releasing a little of this stress.
Maybe I can be open to the possibility of releasing a little of the stress.
Side of the eye. And a little bit of the overwhelm.
And a little bit of the overwhelm.
Under the eye. I'm scared to believe it's possible.
I'm scared to believe it's possible.
Under the nose. I don't believe it's possible.
I don't believe it's possible.
The chin. I really just want to scream sometimes.
I really just want to scream sometimes.
Collarbone. I can't relax.
I can't relax.
Under the arm. I can't ever let my guard down.
I can't ever let my guard down.
Top of the head. I am so tired.
I am so tired.
Soul tired.
Soul tired.
One more here. Back to the eyebrow. All this stress and overwhelm.
All this stress and overwhelm.
Side of the eye. Maybe I can let my guard down a little bit.
Maybe I can let my guard down a little bit.
Under the eye. Maybe I can allow myself to visualize a stress-free moment.
Maybe I can allow myself to visualize a stress-free moment.
Under the nose. Maybe that moment could become an hour and then longer.
Maybe that moment could become an hour and then longer.
The chin. I want to be open to a new way of dealing with this stress.
I want to be open to a new way of dealing with this stress.
Collarbone. Even though I don't have all the answers.
Even though I don't have all the answers.
Under the arm. Even though everything isn't okay.
Even though everything isn't okay.
Top of the head. I give myself permission to breathe and relax.
I give myself permission to breathe and relax.
And last one here. Even though the thought of relaxing seems impossible.
Even though the thought of relaxing seems impossible.
Side of the eye. I give myself permission to relax now.
I give myself permission to relax now.
Under the eye. I recognize the pressure I've been putting on myself.
I recognize the pressure I've been putting on myself.
Under the nose. And I give myself permission to be in this moment.
And I give myself permission to be in this moment.
Chin. I can be kind to myself and offer myself compassion.
I can be kind to myself and offer myself compassion.
collarbone. It is safe for me to let go and trust myself in this moment.
It's safe for me to let go and trust myself in this moment.
Under the arm. I am capable of relaxing for a few moments.
I'm capable of relaxing for a few moments.
Top of the head, and I allow my mind and body to relax and breathe in peace.
I allow my mind and body to relax and breathe in peace.
Pausing and taking that nice deep breath in. And again, just checking in with yourself and seeing, did your number go down? Did your pain get a little bit less? Maybe it moved, maybe it's gone completely. And you're welcome to, you know, put in wherever that pain is. You can save that specific spot if it's, you know, a headache or a shoulder ache, whatever it is, as you know, learn to how to say some of these statements. And the more clear you are with what's actually happening to your body, the better that it will work for you. So I don't know if anyone wants to respond to maybe that. Give me a little feedback on how you're feeling, how that works.
Share this part. It's always important.
Yeah. So what the last thing I'll share with you is maybe some of this looks really big, right? For all of you, if you're, you know, in the middle of some crisis and you're like, oh, hold on a second, I got to do this whole thing, right? And you're like, I don't have time for that, or I don't want somebody to see me doing that. There's something called stealth tapping. So if you look at your hands, and the inside of all of your fingers here are tapping points. You can skip your ring finger. I always tell people to do it anyways, because to me, if I'm stressed, that's the last thing I need to remember, is to skip anything. So you start on the outside of your thumb, then the inside of your fingers, and you just go one by one, and you would say all of your statements on each of these fingers. Here, let me walk up a little bit to the camera as I'm watching. I'm putting my hand here, right? So outside of the thumb. Finger here and here and here and there. And then the other thing you can do is you actually just put your hands together and you do this. And so you just kind of look like you're, you know, just maybe have some nervous energy or something, and people won't really, you know, they're not going to notice or question, and you're hitting all of those points as you're doing it. So this is called stealth tapping. And it's a way that you can help yourself when you're standing there, maybe having a difficult conversation. Or maybe you're just in line at the grocery store and you need to be somewhere and you're getting really frustrated and you feel yourself getting worked up. Well, you just stand at your cart and just do this for a moment. And that's from saying these points here, if you just kind of rub on those points, those are important too. You know, you'll find a lot of times when you have headaches, right? How many of you just rub on your temples? That's the side of your eye, basically. It's that same point. And so when you're feeling that stress and that tension, just rubbing on that, and then just even thinking to yourself, releasing, and telling yourself that, you know, you're sending that message to your brain that I'm safe and I can relax and I can release this now. So those are all just like a few extra little points of some things that you can do for yourself.
And just so you know, yeah, when Danielle taught me how to do this, I was really intimidated by the scripts because I didn't know how to write them or say them. And I used to be a migraine sufferer, and she would teach me how to just say, like, I don't want a migraine. Migraines stink. Why do I have a migraine? These are awful. And I would just go through the same points, just repeating something very basic. And I don't suffer from migraines anymore. And a lot of it has to do with releasing of the stress. And I use this one probably daily. I do. It's just become a real habit of mine to just calm myself with it. So this is really an effective way of releasing anxiety and stress.
Yeah, and the inner part of your wrist is also, you'll sometimes see people just doing that with your wrists and putting them together. And once you've become aware of these points, you'll actually see a lot of people doing this. If you watch sports, you will watch, especially watching the NFL right now, or even the college football, you'll see football players doing this, or you see it in the Olympics a lot. You will see people on the sidelines tapping. It's huge in the sports world for calming down that anxiety of having to perform and be on top of things. It's great for things like, you know, if you have to do public speaking through your work and, you know, or you're going to do it, have an interview or something like that. There's so many wonderful things that you can do with tapping to calm the body down and to stay present and to keep that adrenaline and cortisol lower. So I hope that this was helpful. And then if, you know, there's questions along the way, I would go to that last, I was going to that last screen really, really quick. Hold on. Yeah. 1 second here. Although wait, now I just, okay,
sorry, just go ahead and go around the bottom.
There you go. It's okay. There's my information is around where you can get it. If you need some help, you can have somebody here at North Star send it out to you if you're looking for somebody to work with and to help you work through some of it.
So we are going to also be presenting tomorrow, and we'll be incorporating all of these things that we talked about today in the earlier session and this session. Mm-hmm. And because it's recorded, it's kind of nice. You can go back and practice these, even if you're stressing out and you're like, I don't know what I'm supposed to do with it. It's recorded. So you can have 3 scripts at your fingertips because of this. So yep. Thanks. Cool. Any comments, questions? Very interesting. All right. I put in Danielle's name of her company. You can check her out.
Yep, you can just Google that and you'll find me here. I'm on Stadium in Ann Arbor, so hopefully close to all of you.
All right, cool beans.
Yeah.
We can head on back to our main room.
Yep.
Thanks, everybody, for being a part of it.
Bye.